One of the three people you're about to meet was a Hungarian freedom fighter. What is your name, please?
My name is Toni Balangere. My name is Toni Balangere.
My name is Toni Balangere.
Only one of these people is the real Toni Balangere. The other two are imposters and will try to fool this panel. Tom Poston, Peggy Cass, Orson Bean, and Kitty Carlisle. On to Tell the Truth with your host, Bud Collier.
Tell the truth. Good evening, panel.
Good evening, Bud.
Everybody well and fit tonight?
Yeah. Yes.
Good. Yes. We're brought to you this evening by Winston Filter Cigarettes. Panel, please open your envelope, if you will, and follow along with me on this first story. I, Toni Balangere, am a chorus dancer and a singer. I was born in the United States of a French father and a Hungarian mother. When still a child, we moved to Budapest. During the Hungarian Revolution of 1956, my father was killed. I joined a group of freedom fighters. Using Molotov cocktails, rifles, and grenades, we fought against our oppressors. Finally, we pushed our luck too far, were captured, and sent to a concentration camp. After 11 months, we engineered a prison break. Of the 150 who took part in the escape, all but 15 made it to safety. 4 years ago, I was lucky enough to get out of Hungary and come home to the land of my birth. Signed, Toni Balangere. Panel, these three young ladies all claim to be, as you heard, Toni Balangere, Hungarian freedom fighter. Let's start this questioning with Orson Bean. Orson?
Yes, fine, healthy girls all. Number three, where is the famous bridge that was written about as regards the Hungarian uprising?
Andau.
Number one, where is Andau?
I don't know, I'm sorry.
Number two, do you know?
No,
where Andau is?
I don't know.
Number one again, who wrote The New Class? A book called The New Class, do you know? Number three, do you know who wrote The New Class?
Yes.
Number two, what is Mama Gabor's first name?
Jelly.
Number three, what is a Molotov cocktail?
It's a bottle filled with gasoline.
Number one, it says here that...
Kitty Carlisle.
Number one, which side of the Danube is Buda on?
I beg your pardon, I don't understand.
What side of the...
As to being north or south or east or west?
Yes, east or west of the Danube.
It's north.
And Pest is, number two, is what?
Pest is west.
Is west.
Yes.
Number three, when you throw a Molotov cocktail, how long before you throw it do you pull the stopper out?
Well, you have to pull it out and lit it. And once it's lit, you throw it.
Thank you. Number one, who is the head of Hungary now? Number two, when you left the...
Oh. Tom Poston.
Thank you. Number one, where do you dance?
Where do I dance? It depends. You have to get a booking and you dance.
I'd go along with that. Number two, who was the leader of the people you were fighting against in Hungary?
Thank you, pardon.
Who led the opposition to your freedom movement in Hungary?
When you were trying to escape, you were escaping from whom? Who was the leader of the other side?
Oh, there was Kada.
Thank you.
The leader of the other side.
Yes,
don't listen to him.
The ones who were against you.
Number three, where were you between 4 years ago when you came to the United States and the time you made your escape from the concentration camp?
I was in Budapest for a while.
You escaped from the
Peggy Katz.
Number three, are you a United States citizen?
Yes, I am.
Number one, did you go to the U.S. consulate to help you during the revolution?
Yes, I did.
Well, number three, how could they put a U.S. citizen in a concentration? Oh, I guess they could.
They
oh, number two, what is Tokay?
It's a malt and make a famous wine.
Thank you. Okay, number one, what did Fritz Kreisler write?
I'm sorry, I don't know.
Number three? Oh.
That's all we have time for, but there is time for you still to mark your ballot. So will you do so at once, without change once you've marked, and of course without any consultation whatsoever. Simply vote now for number one, number two, or number three. And our team of challengers will receive $250 for every incorrect vote. Are all your ballots marked?
Yes, sir.
Very well. Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number two because she looked like a, when I first saw her, and then I put myself off, and then finally I came back to that at the end. That's a little confusing, but so is her story.
Peggy Cass, your choice.
Well, I voted for number three because she knew all about Andow. Now, I don't know anything about Andow, and he might have made it all up, but she seemed very good at it, so I voted for her. Did you make it up?
I didn't make it up.
Orson B.
The famous Bridget Andow by James Michener, wasn't it, Bud?
I think so, yes.
And Gilas did indeed write The New Class, who was a former head of Hungary put into prison. I voted for number one, however. He didn't have a lot of facts at her immediate disposal, but she could fight for freedom with me any day of the week.
Kitty Carlisle.
I thought Gilas was Yugoslav.
It could be, but all the more reason not to vote for number two, because she gave me the right answer.
That's why I voted for number three. I think they're all very pretty and terribly knowledgeable, and I admire whoever it was who did it, but I voted for number three because of your question.
Me too.
Well, there's a widely split vote. Two for number three, one for number two, and one for number one. With that, let's find out immediately which one of these young ladies, in truth, can be called a Hungarian freedom fighter. Will the real Toni Balangere please stand up? Thank you very much, and success to you in this country, and thank God that you made it. Now, let's find out about your two friends here who helped you through this evening's or night's. Number two, what is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Lily Martoni, and I'm a cosmetician.
And number three, what is your real name and what do you do?
My name is Alexa Nardushi, and I'm a systems programmer for UNIVAC.
We find you did extremely well, ladies, extremely well. There were three incorrect votes, and that's three times 250 American dollars or $750 for you to divide. That brings the smiles there, and I hope it keeps them there from now on. Thank you for being with us. Goodbye, and God bless you. Well, the panel will be back at it in just a minute, right after this. Now let's meet our next team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is George Schafer.
My name is George Schafer.
My name is George Schafer.
Follow along with your copies of this one, if you will, please, panel. I, George Schafer, am co-author of a recently published book called The Expectant Father. In it, I outline some practical pieces of advice for the men who pay the bills for the over 4 million babies born in this country every year. Among my suggestions for the future fathers of America are these. Cater to the mother-to-be, but don't let her get away with too much. Before the big day, make a timed test run from home to hospital. Don't tell the doctor how to deliver the baby. And if you relieve the tension of the long wait downstairs by going out for a drink, stay sober and don't forget to let the hospital know where you are. My book also contains a chapter on toys and how to buy them and a list of some 700 names and how to choose one. Signed, George Schafer. All right. Panel, these three gentlemen all claim to be George Schafer, who is the proud author of a book entitled The Expectant Father. Let's start this cross-examination with Tom Poston. Tom?
Oh, thank you. Number one, do you believe in natural childbirth? Not yes. for yourself, you understand, but as a potential father.
Yes, yes, definitely.
Number two, do you agree with that, number one?
Yes, I
agree. Have you ever taken the course, number two?
No, I have not.
Number three, do you agree with your two colleagues?
Yes, I do.
So do I, by the way. But have you ever taken the course, number three?
No, I haven't.
Number three, what do the names Mattel and Marks mean to you?
Toy names.
Names of toys. Thank you. Number two, how many children do you actually have?
One.
Did you follow your...
Peggy Cat.
Number one, how many times have you been an expectant father?
I'm not a father.
Number three, how many times have you been an expectant father?
Twice.
It's not so much to write a whole book about it.
Ask a woman his partner had.
Number one, do you believe in having your bag packed? I mean, your wife's bag packed.
Well, it is
to leave for the hospital. Do you believe in packing a bag?
It's good to look ahead.
Thank you. Number three, what good is this time test run doing if it happens in the middle of the night and you've tested it in the middle of the day? I mean, this run...
I would think you'd make out better in the middle of the night with less traffic.
Yes, yeah, I see. So you do it at the worst conditions, I see.
Orson B.
Number three, do you believe that the hospitals are excessively rough on the poor fathers? For instance, they say, don't have a little booze. It is my personal experience that a little booze is good for many things.
I would agree with what you think.
Ah, that's fine. Number one, who is Dr. Laurent?
Dr. Laurent is a French physician.
Number two, do you... All right. Number two, do you agree? Who is Dr. Laurent?
Yes.
All right. Number three, in your hundreds of names, does the name Orson appear? Do you know what it means?
The name Orson appears, but I don't know what it means.
Well, you don't tell why you should name
what does it mean? What does
Wild it mean? Man of the Woods.
It does.
It's a Nordic name. I never knew that until I looked it up.
Keep it dry, Laura.
Number one, what does Dr. Gazelle mean to you?
I'm not familiar with Dr. Gazelle.
Number two, you say in your affidavit here, in this thing that we look at along with Bud, that you believe in keeping the lady who's about to have the baby in order, but where does it say? Wait, I've lost my piece.
Don't let her get away with too much.
Don't let her get away with too much, but pamper a little bit. Now, how do you manage this?
Try to keep everything the way it was before, but don't go overboard.
What do you mean everything the way it was before? I'm going to be the way it was before. It's all changed.
She shouldn't be a vegetable.
Huh? I'm twice a mother,
you're
so don't fool around with me.
And you've only had any of his answers.
Because I'm in a fury.
Your time is
I don't think it's fair for an expectant father to write a book. I don't think he's done well.
All right, Gary, you issue the court if you wish, but mark your ballots. That's the next order, if you will, please. Mark them at once without change, without any consultation whatsoever. Simply vote now without change for number one, number two, or number three. Never heard anybody's chance for questioning talked away so fast in my life. All right, you've all marked, have you? Very well. Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number one. I don't think the people that put this show together would have the guts to put a guy on here with no kids who's supposed to have written a book unless he really had. So I voted for number one.
Peggy Cass, what is your name?
I voted for number one. Because it's just like a man to write a book that's never had a kid on how to have a kid.
All right, that's your vote. Orson, what is your choice?
Well, I didn't vote for number one because Dr. Laurent was, I believe, a fictional French physician, the hero of a movie about natural childbirth starring Jean Gabin. Maybe he wasn't fictional. Number two, who is probably at his nodding his head, no. But number two never took the course. I voted for number three because of the booze.
Carlisle.
I voted for number three because, A, I don't think anybody who wrote a book about children would not know who Gazelle and Elg were, who were famous writers about children. And number three had two children. I also don't believe that anybody who hadn't had any children would be interested in this subject enough to write a book about it. So I'm for number three.
Boy, you're sure loquacious about this particular issue, aren't you? Well, evenly split, two for number one, two for number three. Let's find out immediately which one of these gentlemen, in truth, is the author of a book entitled The Expectant Father. Will the real Dr. George Schafer please stand up?
The doctor?
Thank you, doctor. Just for your information, Dr. Schafer is an associate professor at the Cornell University Hospital Medical School and obstetrician on the staff of Lying In Hospital right here in New York City.
Could we ask who his co-author was? Maybe
yes, you
like
may.
His wife or something.
Milton Sisowitz.
Not your wife. Okay. Thank you.
All right. Number one, what is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Lyle Williams, and I'm a career counselor with Personnel Projection Incorporated.
And number two, what is your real name and what do you do?
My name is Tom Owen, and I am an expectant father.
You must do something else for a living. What do you do?
I'm an administrative assistant at House Beautiful Magazine.
Gentlemen, in checking the score, we find you did well. That was a 50% fooling job. That's always good with this panel, and that means twice $250 or a total of $500 to divide. May it bring you great joy. We thank you for brightening our evening. Goodbye, and God bless you.
Head with Cold's Misery, Dristan.
Now, panel, to introduce our next team of challengers, I'd like you to meet a young man.
My name is Bob McAndrews. One of the next three ladies, young ladies, that you will see will be my wife. I bought her for $40.
What is your name, please?
My name is Sue Ellen McAndrews.
My name is Sue Ellen McAndrews.
My name is Sue Ellen McAndrews.
Follow along while I read this one, panel. I, Sue Ellen McAndrews, married the same man twice within 3 days. I met my future husband, Bob, while we were both serving in the Peace Corps in Africa. In addition to our church wedding, we were married in a native ceremony conducted by the chief of the tribe with which we were working. My father and mother came from the States to witness the ceremony, during which Bob had to promise my father that he wouldn't beat me, that he would try and marry more wives so I wouldn't have to work so hard, and that we arranged to have a boy child as soon as possible. Then Bob had to buy me from my father for $40 a large striped poncho and a white rooster. The chief then told my father that if I wasn't a good wife, Bob could send me back and collect $100 for the trouble I had caused him. Signed, Sue Ellen McAndrews. Lucky man, he gets to kiss all three, huh?
Is he kissing or whispering?
He was kissing. All right, these three young ladies all claim to be Sue Ellen McAndrews' bartered bride, I guess you might call it. We'll start with Kitty Carlisle. Kitty?
Thank you, Bud. Well, whichever one of these ladies Mr. McAndrews bought for $40, he got a terrific bargain. Any one of them is worth a whole lot more. Number one, where were you in the Peace Corps when this ceremony took place?
Liberia.
Number two, who is the head of the Peace Corps?
Sergeant Shriver.
Number three, where is Liberia?
It's on the west coast of Africa.
Thank you. Number one, was this considered a large payment or a medium-sized payment?
I believe it's the general payment that everybody pays.
In other words, you weren't worth more or less?
I don't know yet.
Number two, are you going back?
No, we're not.
Number three, what are you going to do then?
You mean now?
Yes, now.
Oh, we're recruiting for the Peace Corps.
Thank you.
Tom Poston.
That's great. Number two, I just... if you're not really one, I wonder if after the show we could talk. Orson, have you got a 10 you could lend me? Number two...
I'll go in with you for $80, pal.
Number two, where'd you get the poncho? Or where did your husband get the poncho?
He bought it in the village.
And number three, where'd he get that white rooster?
That was given to him by the chief.
Number one, you said that was sort of an average price. Number two, do you agree with that?
I beg your pardon.
Why was $40 a white rooster and a poncho arrived at as the price for you?
No, that's the price for all the brides.
Nope.
Peggy Cass.
Well, number one, say you paid $40 for you. Now, would you get the next one cheaper? No? Like, you wouldn't get them cheaper by the dozen. do without the poncho or something. Number three, did you eat the white rooster?
No.
Number one, what happened to the white rooster?
Well, the villagers ate the white rooster.
I see. Number two, who wore the poncho?
My husband still has the poncho.
Oh, I thought
your father was supposed to get it or something.
Yes, he did get it, but he gave it to Bob.
It's a sport, your father. Number three, why did you decide to have a native ceremony?
We thought that the natives would be very pleased if we did.
Number one, how did he get divorced over there?
Orson Bean.
Number three, does your husband beat you?
Not yet.
Number two, does your husband beat you?
No, he doesn't.
Has he kept his other nuptial agreements?
Yes, he has.
He's brought home other wives to lighten your housework? He hasn't kept them all, I trust, eh?
No.
Number one, tell me about Liberia. Is that a new country?
No.
How old is Liberia?
It was started in 1822.
Number two, did this take place for you in Liberia, too?
No, I was in Gabon.
Gabon. Yeah, tell me about the Gaboon viper, a hated beast that inhabits Gabon. Do you know about this disgusting viper?
No, I don't.
So-called because he bites you in the... I don't want to go into it.
That's all we have time for, I'm happy to say, at the moment. So please mark your ballots. Panel, mark them at once, without change and without any consultation, as you well know. Vote now and swiftly for number one... Number two, or number three? All ballots marked now, are they? Looks like they are now. Okay. Tom, for whom did you vote?
Well, I killed so much time kidding around that I only had the chance to ask number two one lousy question, so I voted for her. I thought that was...
Oh, it's a lousy question. It's a good question. Peggy Cass.
Oh, I voted for number three because when Orson said, and has he brought home any more wives, her eyes gave off sparks. And so I think that it's got to be her because she was sore.
What's the mean? What is your choice?
Well, I'm sure it's number one. They really look like soulmates, but I voted for number two. Because something tells me I'm wrong.
Probably the Gaboon viper.
Yeah, and I don't think that... I've never heard that there were Peace Corps people in Liberia, which is an old established country, whereas Gabon, but I'm probably wrong. What do I know about things like that?
Kitty Carlisle.
Well, that's a good reason. I'm sorry I didn't think of it. I voted for number one. I think they all look like they'd make wonderful wives for Mr. McAndrews, but I think number one and Mr. McAndrews look more like they belong together, and I hope I'm not starting any trouble.
The votes are all in, and the minds, as you heard, are solidly made up on good reasoning. Now, let's find out which of these three lovely young ladies is, in fact, the bartered bride, as I called her. Bob, do us the honor, will you, of showing us which one is the lovely Sue Ellen. Detected a little moment of worry on her face that he might pick the wrong one. Did you notice that?
These two are my second wives, by the way. You have to have more.
Under the contract.
Now, when did he do that?
Yeah. You pick well, I must say. Bob and Sue Ellen were Peace Corps volunteers in Liberia, and they would like to donate their share of the money to help needy Liberian students. And it shall be done. Now, let's find out how much the two pretty partners there. Number two, what is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Ann Lindgren. I do market research for Town Aller & Associates.
Thank you. And number three, what is your real name and what do you do?
My name is Susan Walton. I'm the buyer of art books for the Rizzoli International Bookstore.
Ladies and gentlemen, the score did very well. There were three incorrect votes that you let our panelists into, and that's skillful leading, believe me, by the nose or otherwise. It's a total of $750 that you take along to divide. And we thank you very much for sharing your evening with us. Goodbye, much happiness to you, and God bless you all.
Good night.
Good night for Winston. And don't forget to join us this week at this same time. And of course, I'll see you tomorrow afternoon on the daytime show. But in the meantime, don't you forget to tell the truth. Bye.
To Tell the Truth is a Mark Goodson, Bill Cotman production. Has been brought to you tonight by Winston Filter Cigarettes. Winston tastes good like a cigarette should. This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Tell the Truth, the program for the course.